it's important to distinguish the big hurts of life and the little irritating things of life that I need to let go of. Sometimes I hold on to someone's remark or a hurtful comment or a disagreement, and I want to hold on to it like it's a war crime, when I'm just really just being petty. Jesus might say to us in those situations, build a bridge, walk over it. But what do you do? What do you do with the big hurts, the serious wounds, the invasive betrayals that assault our lives? Jesus taught us to pray. He taught us to pray and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. You know what Jesus says? He says, we have debtors, meaning we have people who owe us. They have hurt us. They have wronged us. Jesus is not in denial, and yet he says, forgive them. But I don't want to forgive them. They owe me. And then Paul has the audacity to write in Romans 12, don't repay anyone evil with evil. Don't take revenge. Leave that for God's wrath. It is mine, says the Lord, to avenge. I will repay. But I want to get even. I dream about it. I obsess about it. I plan it all out in my head. When Narvaez, the Spanish patriot, lie dying, his priest asked whether he had forgiven all his enemies. And Narvaez looked astonished and said, Father, I have no enemies. I have shot them all. You see, the problem with getting even is that no two people weigh pain on the same scale. Will the Palestinians ever get even with the Israelis, or the Syrian government with the jihadist militants? Or will the 18th Street gang ever get even with the Florentia 13 gang on the streets of eastern Los Angeles? Never. The answer is no. They may go on killing each other until they are all dead, but they will never get even. Lewis Smead says, when you forgive someone, you are dancing to the rhythm of the divine heartbeat. God invented forgiveness as the only way to keep his romance with the human race alive. Forgiveness may be the most difficult act of love. Picture Jesus hanging on the cross, violated, beaten, abused, and he says what? Father, forgive them, for they know not what they're doing.